Hello everyone, I'm Larry and I'm going to show you how to download Xilinx or Xilinx, however you prefer, the ISE. So I'm going to go to this link right here. I'm going to leave a link to this or this link into the description to download it. You're going to want to skip a lot of these. You don't need any of these. You're going to want to come down here. You don't want to download this one. Not going to download this one because we're on Windows. We want this one. You might get this one right here. You don't want this one. So we're going to go to 14.7 and come down to this one. Now you're going to click this link and it's going to download. Oh, first it wants to sign in. Sign in. Yep. So it's going to start downloading. Now this is a very large file. It's going to take probably like an hour or so, or maybe even more. So you're just going to want to leave this here and I'm going to come back when it's finished downloading. Okay. Quick disclaimer. When you're downloading Xilinx, it's going to want you to have an account. So just keep that in mind. I already had an account, so it already signed me in, but you're just going to create an account. And it's going to have fields like these that you're going to have to enter your information in. So just enter those and then you should be all good. All right, so Xilinx has finished downloading. So we just go to our downloads folder and this should be it. So we just take this to the desktop. So you're going to need a program called 7-Zip. And I'll leave a description or a link to the download in the description. And you should just download that and install it. It takes only like 3 seconds to install. So I'm going to come down here, come to 7-Zip, and I'm going to say extract files. And then I'll just accept that. So now what it's going to do is it's going to open this file and it's going to create this file right here. And it's not going to have much, it's going to have this right here. So as it finishes up, it's going to have a executable, I guess you can call it, to launch the setup wizard, which will help us install the install it. Okay. So it's finished extracting the files, and what we're going to do is we're going to select this one right here. So we're going to double click. We're going to say yes. And so now it's going to start installing. So it wants us to turn off our antivirus. Really doesn't matter. We're going to accept this one. We're going to choose this one, ISE Webpack. Because this just gives us the general stuff that we're going to need. Just keep all of these default. And I recommend keeping this as the default stuff. Because if you choose something else, it's going to like screw everything up. And you're not going to be able to access the things that you need to access. So we're going to click next and we're going to click install. And this is going to take, I don't know, probably 15 minutes to do, or maybe 10. So I'll be right back. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go to our C drive, this thing right here. So you're going to open up a, you can just click on this icon or click a file on your computer. And you're going to see this PC. You're going to want to open this, go to C drive, and then you're going to see the Xilinx folder. So we're going to go in there, go to 14.7. Go to this ISE_DX. We're going to go to ISE. And then we're going to go to a file called LIB. Let's see if I can find it here. There it is. We're going to go there. And then we're going to go to NT64. And then we're going to look for a file called libportability. So I see lib, go way down, we're at the P's, There it is, lib portability. So what we're going to do is we're going to have to select this, and then we're going to have to rename it. It says .dll, and what you're going to want to do is add .orig and press enter. And then what we're going to also do is we're going to copy this one right here. So let's copy it, and then select off, and then we're going to paste it again, paste it. And see, it says copy. So what we're going to do is we're going to rename it. We're going to get rid of that copy and the nosh. So it's almost the same name as this one right here. And we're going to press enter. And so we've copied this one, but we're going to have to paste this one, this one right here. We're going to have to paste it in another folder. So we want to go to go back to the ISE or to the ISE underscore DS, and we're going to go to common folder. And then we're going to go to the lib nt64, and then we're going to paste it. It's going to be right here. We're going to rename this one .orig, enter, and then we're going to get rid of this this nosh right here. Press enter. And so that should be about it. So we're going to exit this. Now I'm going to click on it again, and now it's going to launch. We're going to press OK, and now it's going to say that it needs a license. So we're going to say OK, and then we're going to OK. So here it goes. So we're going to, so it's going to have automatically selected on acquire a license, get my purchase license. We're going to say next, and then it's going to ask you to it's going to ask to connect to your default browser. So we're going to say yes, and it should open up a link on the Xilinx page. It's going to ask you to log in. Click next. Okay, so once you get to this page, it's going to have a Xilinx license folder. Not, you don't want any of these. It's going to, I only have two here that say that the subscription end date is none. There's going to be a third. You want to select that one. You don't want this one or this one. And then you're going to get an email after you select it. You're going to come down here and click download on the email. You're going to find this and click download. So now I've got this file here. So now when I go to here, I'm gonna click load license, and then it's gonna ask me to find it. I'm gonna click on this one and say open. And then it's gonna say that the license installation was successful. So now we're all good to go. We're gonna close this, and now we're all free and ready to make projects in Xilinx. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you need any help, make a comment and put it in the comment section, and I'll try and answer you. Thank you very much.